Only when you are seated down. Only when you are order. Only when you are in an order. Order. Our vijana hawa. Our vijana. Hii omera kijana hii. Hii kijana hii. This boy here. This boy here. Wendy man. Wacha ujinga hapa, usilete ujinga. Hapa ulete ujinga. Morara.
Oke kwani. Mazini go adopta kanaisi. They are not
order, order. Hatuendi, hatuendi. 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 Hapa ndio tunakuwa, hey, wewe. Hatuendi. Hatuendi.
Tere ni jere digo mlo kwanyoke.
Order, order, order. Can we secure those papers? Can we secure the papers?
Huyu kijana huyu.
Wewe wezi kuja kuharibu mkutano ya public participation. Order. Everyone has an opinion.
Order.
Piga. Wacheni kupigana. Marara. You cannot come to destroy a meeting.
Na musiende. Musiende.
Aya, nyamaza, nyamaza, nyamaza.
Aya, ketini chini.
Wapi?
Aya, tukae chini.
Why I'm saying we should impeach both of them. Now, the Gen Z movement is not leaderless anymore. We are trying to prove that we can offer alternative leadership and that people have been born in this country who are leaders of integrity and that can presume power and lead the country to a better place. That we don't have to choose among thieves. That we can raise leaders of integrity and actually install them into power. And they are rising from that movement, and we should not bring them down. But one of the things that a person must have to rise to that level is political experience. And I have a lot of it. And when I look at this situation politically, this is my assessment. I could be right, I could be wrong. I accept that. But the way I'm looking at it is that if we push for an impeachment of Gachagua alone, then it's going to blow back because people in Mount Kenya are not seeing things the way we are seeing them. For us who demand accountability and good governance, some people in Mount Kenya, not all of them, are seeing this as a fight against a Kikuyu. They're saying, ni mwizi lakini ni wetu. Kwa nini mnampiga yeye peke yake? Kwani yeye peke yake ndiye ameiba? That's how people are thinking in the villages. And I'm very sad that they are already thinking this wakati bado sijawafikia na civic education. But already that's what people are thinking. You can see even member of parliament who signed the impeachment motion, some of them are pulling back because the ground is becoming hostile for them. They have their citizens saying, kwa nini mnataka kumuimpeach? So Kenyans have not yet understood that, you know, we stand for accountability and that we want good governance and that it doesn't matter mtu ameiba kama ni wakabila yako ama si wakabila yako. At the end of the day, hakuiba ili wewe usaidike, aliiba ili ajisaidie. The best way to do this, the best way to convince an old mama mwenye ako huko Geshagi, mwenye anasema Gachagua ni wetu, huyo ni mtoto wetu, wachana na yeye, yet this person is being accused of very serious things, which is corruption. The only way to disarm that person is to say, let's impeach them both. Because honestly speaking, whatever Gachagua has done, Ruto has done it 10 times, if not 50 times, if not 100 times. So why only impeach Gachagua? Why? Then what are you saying even about Didmus Barasa, who is an MP that has bought an helicopter worth about 300 million. Where did he get the money? Why are we not asking? We are asking Gachagua where he got the hotels. Very good. But why are we not asking these other people where they got such wealth that they have? Why are we not questioning Murkomen or Oscar Sudi or Davis Churchill, how he acquired his wealth? We need to be asking these people, We have a cabinet that was dismissed. That cabinet was dismissed, but some of the people that were in that cabinet were corrupt. Hawajarudisha pesa yetu? Wameenda wapi na pesa yetu? Why should somebody be fired from the cabinet naende na pesa yetu? So this is what I think. Politically speaking, if you keep pushing for only Gachagua to be impeached, you are earning him sympathy. And as you earn him sympathy, you are creating a presidential candidate. And you are creating a presidential candidate that has 4 million Mount Kenya votes, meaning he is already part of the two-horse race. Meaning utakuwa unaingia kwa debe 2027, unachagua between Mwizi A na Mwizi B. Meaning you are not safe. And this has been the situation in many elections in Kenya. This has been the situation, unaingia kwa debe, you don't even, hadi wa Kenya wameacha kuvote. Because unaingia kwa debe, unapata wezi ni wawili, wao ndio front runner, wao ndio wako na chance ya kuwin. Sasa uchague, who are you choosing between these two corrupt people? We need to change Kenya and we need to be able to bring to the fourth leaders of integrity. And the only way to do that is anything regarding corruption, let's not put tribe into it. Tusilete mambo ya ukabila hapo. Because hata kama mwizi ni mkalenjin, anawasaidiaje? For example, seme Hillary Balchok ameibia watu wa Bomet. Kwani yeye ni mwakabila ingine? Si yeye ni mkale kama hao watu wa Bomet? Is a Kipsi, is a the rest of them? Meaning mtu anawakula ni wenu? Let's not defend corruption. Let us say let's impeach them both because they are both corrupt. They are both failed Kenyans. They came as a package. Why is one leaving? They should leave as a package so that we have a fresh start. This is the position that I'm trying to convince my fellow youth in Kenya to join me in standing for that position. I'm not saying let's defend one. I'm saying let both of them go. Yeah? And that will be the best way to move forward. Otherwise, we will create sympathy for Gachagua and we will jump in 2027, we will jump from the frying pan direct into the fire. So we need to kill that Gachagua wave very early. And the only way to kill it is he should not be prosecuted alone. They should be together with other people so that it doesn't become a matter of tribe, it becomes a matter of accountability. I hope mmenielewa. As I said when I started this video, nilisema, for anybody to rise to the level of being a leader in this movement, right? I'm not saying a leader of the movement. Personally, I believe you can only be part of a movement, but not, you can't own a movement. So for you to be a leader in this movement, you should start having political experience. We should be thinking about what are the political implications of what we are doing. And how do we disassociate tribalism from our politics? Na nataka ku encourage watu wote who are people of integrity and even young people and Gen X and millennials. Rise up, join the Inject Party. Let us start agitating for good leadership in our country. I know some of you are wondering what I'm planning to do with this party. Mnasema, ai, chama Kenya inakuanga kampuni ya mtu, inakuanga personal property ya mtu, hii ni chama ya morara. This is your party, my friends. In fact, mimi siogopi ati mtapigana kwa chama. That is a political process. Kujeni, mpigane, mkimaliza, muelewani. And I'm inviting everybody, even the Twitter bigwigs, kina Anifa, Americs, Cornelius Rono, Mwamba, Kimuzi, Nelson Ameya, and all those people, wenye mkona followers wengi, and even wenye amuna followers, everybody matters. Come to your home, pale Kawasukari, kujeni mkai. Kujeni mseme, we don't want Morara to be the leader of this movement, we want to impeach him. Sawa, tupige kura hapo. Mginishinda, sawa. But come and own the party, let it be yours. Wacheni kusema tutakaa inje, tutatengeneza yetu. Na hata kama mtatengeneza yenu, tengenezeni yenu ili tuanze kujitayarisha kufanya coalition uko mbele. Build your party, uko mbele tutafanya coalition. Mimi sijakataa mtu asifanye yake. Just do your thing. If you want to join, come and join. This is not personal property. Na mimi hakuna direct nomination napea mtu. There's nobody will be given a direct nomination. Unakuja unangangana, kama umepata ni yako. Kama hujapata, pole, wakati mwingine. We must do things democratically. The reason political parties are not strong in Kenya is because people are owning them like personal property. People are using them as private limited companies to loot public funds and to acquire deals with government. They are using them to negotiate for deals. Political party should be a process. It should be owned by the members. Mimi hata kitu napanga kufanya, sinyi ni my youth, si ni chama yenu, tengenezeni a blockchain election system. Ule wale ma IT guru wenye wako, tengenezeni an election system based on blockchain. Any member of the party on any issue, tunaweka online, watu wanavote. Even if we have 5 million members, watu wanavote within 10 seconds, we already know what the decision of the people is. That way, we can even tell IBC, kwa nini mnatuambia we cannot vote electronically, yet we've managed it in our party. Give the party to its members. Let members own the party. Don't fear that, oh, they'll impeach you. You know, if you leave this party to members to run out of control, oh, members will fight. Let members fight. It's their party. They'll fight and agree. Yeah? So tupatane huko kwa public participation. I had posted on my social media pages where public participation will be happening today. Make sure umefika huko. Make your voice heard. And if you are my supporter, position ni impeach both of them so that we remove tribalism from this thing. We make it an issue of accountability.
Yeah, huyo ni Kebaso Morara kabla na baada ya Bomas pale ambapo ameweza kuvamiwa na watu ambao walikuwa pale kwenye Bomas niseme security ama wengi wanasema kwamba ni maguns ambao wameweza kumuattack pale Bomas. So baadaye Morara aliweza kufurushwa na kuenda. Sasa sijui na maoni gani kuhusiana na kisa ambacho kimefanyika pale Bomas, kama ni haki ama imekuwa jambo la haibu. Niachie maoni yako hapo kwenye comment section, kama uje subscribe kwenye Wasos TV na kuomba uweze kusubscribe.